ओम अक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभ द्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरां गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुर्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। आवर टॉपिक इज पंचदशी 15th chapter. So very nice name is given by our Vidyaranya Swami. If you write anything, any book, you have so much of headache to give some nice name for the book. Suppose you write some poem. So what kind of poem, what kind of name we can give to our own poem? How many lines you have written? Just 4 lines. About whom? About my own autograph, my own life, autobiography. You know, simple poem also, simple book also, if you write, we need to have very nice title, nice name should be given. So our Vidyaranya Swami, the name of Vidyaranya Swami itself says that this is Aranya of Vidya, forest of Vidya. Very nice name he has given for his book, Panchadashi. Panchadasi. Panchadasi means for that 15 chapter, that's all. Why it's 15 chapter? The name of the book is 15 chapter. Not 15th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Not 15th chapter, 15 chapter. Why book has got 15 chapters? Therefore, the name of the book is 15 chapter book, that's all. So very nicely we can take this kind of message for our, simply we can, no need to break our head. Brainstorming, there's no need. Suppose you write 10 chapters, dasa, okay, pancha, it's a pancha dasi, 15 chapters he has written, and the name he has given to his book is called pancha dasi, so 15 chapter. So we are going to see the 15th chapter of 15 chapter. What? The last chapter of pancha dasi. What about the 14th? Understood. First 14, understood. Therefore, we are going to study the 15th chapter, last chapter of Panchadasi. Okay? Now, see, this Panchadasi, well, the content of this Panchadasi, 15th chapter is happiness, about happiness. So, what is real happiness? How to get it? 2 questions. So, what we are enjoying, the happiness, is not real happiness. How we enjoy happiness? When you sleep, happy. You see, after half an hour, you see. Yes, they're happy. When you drink something, oh, happy. When we eat something, happy. Getting a nice car, oh, happy. Nice big house. After that, we have to maintain. That is a different matter, but big bungalow house, happy. We get position in our company. Oh, you happy. Power. Happy, happy. Money comes. Oh, not money comes. Money flows like a river. Not out of our bank account. It's coming towards the bank account. Happy. All this happiness are happiness. But not real happiness. Why? These are all not permanent happiness. So all the Vedantic the message is telling that all this happiness, whatever we are enjoying, adhyantav, adhyanta, it has got a beginning and it has got end. Adhyantavanta kaundena teshu ramate buddhaha. The buddhiman, the wise man will not dwell in this kind of happiness. So we have to ask, what is real happiness? Then you tell me, what is real happiness? How to get it? The 2 questions. How to get it? What is real happiness? This is the content of the 5 days, yajna. Okay. In this 5 days, we are going to see what is the real happiness, how to get it. The practical way. Okay. This is not, it's not giving only theory part. Our Vidyarini Swami, very, very practical person. Very genius person. So every text, wherever you, whatever the text you take, the teacher of that text will bring the idea. But this teacher of the text is brilliant person. Why brilliant person? If you study the sloka by sloka, thought by thought, I tell you one very nice thing that if you have intellect, yeah, definitely we have intellect. There is no doubt about it, okay? For study's sake only I'm telling. If you have intellect, then if you want to get complete satisfaction of the intellect, complete satisfaction, the properly working intellect, and we are craving to get a satisfaction, and want to get nice thought, nice what that food for the thoughts, then you have to study Panchadasi. Panchadasi is only the best text in the world to satisfy the human intellect. Gurudev, our Gurudev Swami Chinmayanji, he studied from our Tapovan Maharaj. The first text is Panchadasi. When we go to Sandipani, first text is Bhajagovindam. Bhajagovindam itself is very difficult to bear. People run away from Bhajagovindam. First week, second week, so many dropouts will be there. Sandipani. Then afterwards, Tattvabodham, finished. Tattvabodham, it's very difficult to bear. Panchadasha, highest text, highest Prakarna Grantha of the Vedanta, Gurudev studied this book as a first book. You see the intellectual ability of our Gurudev. But I tell you, a challenge. After studying the 3 years of Vedanta course also, if you take Panchadasi, it's very challenging only. Very, very subtle thoughts. But you will enjoy these thoughts like anything. Brilliant book. Okay, now we are going to search the happiness. I'm not telling this is a tough book. This is not tough. This is very, very intricate, very subtle thoughts. You will enjoy. Oh, how we enjoy this food. How we make food. So many masalas, so many things we add, and the flavor, this and that, very particular kind of the what do you call, the heat you make it. Very delicious, very peculiar food if you make, to enjoy in the same way. Very peculiar kind of, what do you call, the emotional joy also we need to have. In the same way, very, very subtle, very deep kind of satisfaction you get when you study Panchadasi. We'll see. After 5 days, you'll ask. First day, you told so much. I see nothing in this. Sir, you have to enjoy. You drink so many coffees, but you like one brand coffee so much. Other people, what is there to enjoy? Sir, you should know how to enjoy this bitterness of the coffee. The same way. There is no bitterness. Excuse me. Here is only sweetness. Subtle ideas you'll enjoy, okay? This is our content. The content of the 5 days, yajnas, how to, what is real happiness, how to get it. Now, this book, Panchadasi, has got 3 sections, 15 chapters. 15 chapters are divided into 3 sections, major sections. If it is Bhagavad Gita, 18 chapters. The Bhagavad Gita itself is a major book. 18 chapters have taken from Mahabharata. Every chapter is unique and it has got connection. Here the 15 chapters are divided into 3 sections, Viveka Prakarana, Deepa Prakarana and Ananda Prakarana. Vivekam, Deepam, Ananda. Really brilliant person. See how he kept the name. For this book, you can give him 15 PhDs. All original thoughts. It's not thought improved on some book. If it is commentary, you are writing commentary on the original text. This is not original text. This is not a commentary on original text. He reflected from the Upanishad and Bhagavad Gita, all the text, and he himself created it. The creation of a new text, new thoughts, 15 PhDs. Viveka Prakarana, 5 chapters. Deepa Prakarana, 5 chapters. Ananda Prakarana, 5 chapters. Total 15 chapters. Very simple. Very, very simple. So the name is given Viveka. Viveka is to discuss with you discrimination. Deepam, the discussion on consciousness, chit. Ananda is a discussion on Ananda, the joy, bliss. What is the nature of Brahman, Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam, Brahma? See that? He has gone to the top. From there he picked up. Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam, Brahma. Sattu, Chitta, Ananda. If somebody asks us, you give talk on Sattu, Chitta, Ananda, only 5 minutes, that's all. Sattu, Chitta, Ananda, that's all. So you do not know how to elaborate it. Taking Sat, he has written 5 chapters. Taking Chit, 5 chapters. Taking Ananda, 5 chapters. So we have to appreciate our Indian thinkers. So our view about our great acharyas, we just see them as a Swami, a Sadhu, that's all. Swami, Sadhu. You keep them in the spiritual hall, worship them, do some ashtotra namavali. That's all. Sir, you break in, come out, and see there the brilliance of academic work. 15 PhDs, the academic work. What kind of title they are giving? How they are taking the root from the Upanishad? How they are elaborating it? Thought by thought, how they are brilliant teachers, brilliant lecturers, brilliant professors. So we need to change our views from spiritual thing into academic side also. I hope you understand what I'm telling. But whenever we see some text, spiritual books, spiritual master, we will bring them in small circle, we put them in that packet, close it up. Sir, they're all great people, more than professors. See the teaching method, how they are bringing thought by thought. So hereafter we have to change our view. Even though we belong to spiritual field, in the spiritual field also we need to find the academic approach and the scientific approach or logical reasoning. It is there, so much of thing. So we have to bring that also into this. Okay, now first 5 chapters. This is the first 5 chapters. He is given the name. తత్వ వివేక ప్రకరణ, మహాభూత ప్రకరణ, పంచకోశ వివేక వివేక ప్రకరణ, ద్వైత వివేకపురం, మహావాక్య వివేక. బై ద నేమ్, బై రీడింగ్ ద నేమ్ యూ కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్ వాట్ విల్ బి ద కంటెంట్ ఆఫ్ ద టాపిక్ చాప్టర్. తత్వ వివేకం, మహాభూత, పంచ మహాభూత, స్టడీ అబౌట్ పంచమహాభూ, పంచకోశ, ద్వైత, ద క్రియేషన్, Mahavakya, all these 4 Mahavakyas. By reading the name, you can understand what will be the content. Okay, now, 5 chapters going to Deepam, Chit, consciousness. He has even given the name, the relevant name for the consciousness, Deepam. Brilliant person. Now, what kind of the brain it is? Chitra Deepa. తృప్తి దీప ప్రకరణం, కూటస్థ దీప, ధ్యాన దీప, నాటక దీప. వెరీ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్, దిస్ నాటకం ఇస్ టేకన్. నాటకం, ఇట్స్ అ డ్రామా. హీ హాస్ టేకన్ ద డ్రామా అండ్ బ్రాట్ వెరీ బ్రిలియంట్ థాట్ ఆఫ్ వేదాంత త్రూ డ్రామా. అయ్యో, నాటక దీపం, వెరీ బ్రిలియంట్ ప్రెసెంటేషన్. వెన్ యు స్టడీ ద నాటక దీపం, ద డ్రామా, how he brings the deeper meaning of Vedanta through drama. So after studying this, so the Shakespeare's all the world stage, that is nothing, simple. But they made it so popular. But this is deeper than that, so deeper. Okay, subject. Next 3 chapters are Ananda. Yoga Ananda Prakarana, Atma Ananda Prakarana, Advaita Ananda Prakarana, Vidya Ananda Prakarana, Vishaya Ananda Prakarana. All Ananda Prakarana. యోగానంద, ఆత్మానంద, విద్యానంద, అద్వైతానంద, విషయానంద, ఆల్ ఆనంద ఆనంద. నౌ అవర్ టాపిక్ ఇస్ విషయానంద ప్రకరణ. Vishayananda means the bliss, the pleasure. So what kind of pleasure we are, the jiva is enjoying this world. Our Swami, Vidyarani Swami has taken up this Vishaya Prakarana, Vishayam. The pleasure, worldly pleasure he has taken for his discussion. Worldly pleasures for the discussion, yeah. Eating, drinking, sleeping, whatever we are doing and enjoying this world. So he has taken, picked up that topic. You are already there in the pleasure of the world. So he is taking the subject from the pleasure of the world. It's very easy for us to attract for the subject. See the psychology. Suppose you ask all of the people, you come, I will start with that yogasana. Many people will run away. No, yogasana I cannot. You come, we'll start with mathematics. Ayyo. We'll come, I'll start with scientific concept, then I'll teach you the Vedanta. For that, brain is needed. I don't have a brain, I will not come to this Vedanta class. Now, he's talking, already you are enjoying pleasure. Yeah. You come, I will show you another bliss through the pleasure. So how he is attracting the student by picking up the Vishayananda. Okay? So much of psychology is involved, ideas involved. Super personality, our Vidyarani Swami. So our topic is Vishayananda Prakarana, bliss of Vishaya. Whatever the joy we enjoy, okay? The pleasure. Vishayananda means pleasure. Through the sense organs, through the mind, whatever we enjoy, that is called pleasure. That's all. Bliss is beyond five sense organs, beyond mind is called bliss. For the pleasure, there is a, what that? So this translation is not good. I will change it. Bliss of Vishaya is there in many books. The pleasure of Vishaya is the right word. But in many books, it is called bliss of Vishaya. Pleasure is the right word. Pleasure has got opposite word, pain. Sukha dukkha. Are you okay with me? Sukham has got the opposite word, dukkham. So pleasure and pain. And pain and pleasure. So ananda, this ananda does not have the opposite. You cannot say anananda. Ananda doesn't have opposite. Ananda, bliss, that's all. So while we are living in this in a Prakrita Loka or the Vyavahara Loka, you have opposite word. Sukha, Dukkha, Labha, Nashta. If we go beyond the Vyavahara world, only Ananda is there. Therefore, Satyam Jnanam Anantam, Anandam is given. Satyam Jnanam, Sukham is not indicated. Satyam Jnanam Ananda. Sattu Chitta Ananda. Is it okay? Now. So before entering into the subject, we need to touch few points, then we'll go into the subject. Okay? Now, this sloka from Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam, Vidura and Maitreya has got the discussion, the beginning of the Bhagavatam. Vidura and Maitreya. These two people are discussing many things in the Himalayas. So Vidura is visiting, Vidura meets our Maitreya Rishi. And Vidura asks so many questions. One very brilliant question. This question is needed for us in our life. Our question is asked by Vidura to Maitreya Rishi. Sukhaya karmani karoti lokaha. All these people, in this world, people are various actions. The people do various actions. From this, they never get happiness. Yes, perfectly. In this world, various activities we are doing, we are not getting happiness. All these activities are done for happiness. But not getting happiness. What is this? I thought I will get happiness. Instead of happiness, I will get some other thing. Sukhaya karmani karoti loka na taihi sukham va anyat uparamam va. They are not getting sukham uparamam. The sukham means the happiness. I am not getting, neither get happiness, nor are they able to get over unhappiness. Getting over unhappiness, uparata means relief. Yeah, relief. So getting relief from the problem itself is happiness. I don't want to get new happiness. First, let me come out of problem. If I come out of problem, that itself is Habba, the kind of peace I'm getting. Uparama means getting out of problem. Sukha means after solving the problem, we get joy. But the both the things I'm not getting by doing this kind of activities. Sukhaya karmani karoti lokaha na taihi sukham va anyat uparamam. So I'm not getting relief and I'm not getting sukham. Vindeta bhuyaha. One more thing is telling. Instead of getting relief and sukham, bhuyaha, again I'm getting more dukkham. A brilliant presentation of Vidura. Vidura is asking the question. Because when you analyze the life, then only we'll get this kind of question. No analysis, no reflection when we do, we'll not get this kind of question. So we become so dull and tamasic. The person one who analyzes, this person will get this kind of brilliant question. Actually speaking, I'm not getting sukha, not getting relief. I'm getting more and more dukkham only. Yadattara yuktam bhagavan vadet nahas. I do not know. Please tell us what is the best for the man to do in life. Now you tell me what is the best thing to do in life to get happiness. Nice question. Le? What will be the answer? This answer also you will get in Panchadashi. But Maitri Rishi is telling different stories. So if you take that route, then you have to land in Bhagavadam. The question is a very brilliant question. That's why I have taken from Srimad Bhagavadam. Okay? Third Kando, 5th chapter, 2nd Sloka. The same kind of the question is asked. The topic is discussed in the Navayogi Prasangam. We have studied last week, last year, I think. Eh? Navayogi Prasangam. Might be. We are studying so many things, but we don't remember what we have studied. Navayogi Prasangam. Last year, we studied Navayogi Prasangam. La Prabuddha, one of the yogis, he was telling that karmani aarabhamananam dukkha hati sukhaya cha. We all start our karma to kill dukkha to get sukha. Dukkha hati sukhaya cha. To get happiness and to kill all the, what do you call it, dukkha hati. Pashyetu paka viparyasam. I see in reverse direction. Instead of getting happiness, I'm getting only. All things, we want to live very happily by building big house. 1 week only we are happy. After that, the problem starts. The person who has given the loan, he is asking. After 1 week, now only I entered into this house here. Yeah. Now you are asking money. Wait. Getting the car. That I do not know how to start the car, how to maintain the car. Yo. People are, oh, you got, what a great, the world's star. Number one car you got. Yes, number you. Small pleasure we are getting from outside, but inside we only know how to handle this car inside my house. Suffering so much when we come out, oh, you have so very nice car. A few words only we are hearing and we are enjoying, but inside we are suffering like anything. When you analyze each and everything. Brilliant life of Vedanta. Udukka hatte sukaya che. One must observe how human beings live in pairs. The Midhuri Charinam Dhrana means people are living in the family. Striving to gain happiness and remove misery, obtain only contrary result. Throughout the life, it's happening. Still, we are trying to get something. We are trying again and again, we are trying to get something, but we are not getting the real happiness. Whatever we are getting, the pleasure. That pleasure also, when we get it, people are not allowing us to enjoy. They're disturbance. Another point from same Bhagavad. One more point. This is a very brilliant point. Same Bhagavad only. All this collection of the thoughts, which are very much needed for our Panchadasi. Okay, therefore I brought this idea. Another point from Bhagavad. All attempts to get to our sufferings are like a man carrying a load on his head. The man is carrying the load on his head and shifting it to his shoulder. The shoulder is shifting. All over the world. Very nice. Now see. Yatahi purushaha baram. Baram, he has this weight load. Baram. Sirasa gurum udvahan. Sirasa, he kept his load on his head. walking 1 kilometer or 1 mile. After that, so he has taken from his head and put it on his shoulder. A shoulder, if he puts on his shoulder, he's relaxed, relief. He's getting little relief from the head. Now the problem started from the shoulder. We have a very interesting idea. Tamskandena saadate, from sirasu. So he has shifted the bharam from head to shoulder. Tata sarva pratikriya. Like that, all our activities are in our life like this only. We try to change the problem. Try to shift the problem from one place to another place. That's all. So we are not here to solve the problem once for all. Very nice the idea, the message from Srimad Bhagavat. This is from 4th canto, 29th chapter, 23rd sloka. Okay, we lived life, whatever you told from the 3 slokas, it's what happening in my life. Now you tell me what is real happiness. Now we are entered into real happiness. Okay. We try to get happiness in this world. But I make effort. I'm ready to make effort. I'm a very dynamic person. I want to get happiness, but where I'm searching? What is real happiness? We are very much blessed to get Panchadasi. Through Panchadasi, we are going to find out what is real happiness. And thereafter, we make effort to get it. Okay? Now, it's very this story, you know, the old lady. Senior citizen, pa, are you old lady? I should not say. Senior citizen. The senior citizen, this amma, this lady, has got some needle. She lost her needle. Already she's old, eyes are not highly visible, not very sharp. She lost the house where she is living. She came out. We used to say veranda, right? So there you don't have veranda, only house, that's all. Here in India, you have veranda, outside veranda. The lady comes out and started searching veranda. Okay, old lady searching veranda. People are walking in the street. They come. They have compassionate heart. They come in. Pati, what are you searching? And she said, needle da, needle. Okay, I will help you. And the person comes and start helping, searching here and there, unable to find. Another person also comes, because 2 people are searching. I should also help, social service. The person comes, and he also joins with them. He's also unable to. The third person comes, he studied Vedanta like us, okay? Brilliant boy. This person asks, Pati, what are they searching? Hey, 2 of you, what are you doing? We are helping Pati and we are searching needle. Okay. How long are you searching? More than 10 minutes you are searching. Okay, because he studied Vedanta, brilliant person. Hey, he started asking Pati, Pati, actually, where did you lose this? Pati says, inside the house, da. These 2 people become, you lost inside and searching outside. What is this? Now here only I have little light, therefore I'm searching. Here I have little light, you are searching this. Sir, where you lost, there only how to search. Okay? So we lost this happiness inside, but we are searching outside. That's all. So now we have to try to search inside. Therefore, this is called Atma Vidya. Self-study. Study about our own self. Okay? Now, happiness is a subjective, not objective. First, we have to turn our view. Otherwise, you will go and search outside only. Position, power, money, all the things. It is there. Pleasure is there, not happiness, not bliss. So we should not, when we study happy, when you study Vedantic text, we should not. Do you enjoy this ice cream? No. We should not say that. Sir, there is joy in the ice cream when you eat it. But that jaya is called pressure. That's all. We should not say, we should not criticize or blame all the, when God created, he kept this happiness there. So he has given the the project for us, for the human being. Pleasures will be there. You should not go behind the pleasure. You have to turn your mind, bring your mind back, go inside and find bliss. That is a life project. That's all. Hide and seek. It's kept inside, but you are trying to get outside. Stop searching outside. Go inside, get in. If you get it, then you are coming out of the game. Game is over. That's all. You got it. Cup will be given. What is the cup? Medal? Liberation is a medal. That's all. Very nice kind of a game. Okay? Now, see how to turn inside. You turn, you also turn inside. That's all. Now we are turning inside. We are studying about our own self. Okay? Now, what is Vishayananda? This is our topic. We will go and study. This is the first sloka of this Panchadashi. Okay?
अतः अत्र विषयानंदो ब्रह्मानंदांश रूपवाक् निरूप्यते तद्द्वारभूत निरूप्यते द्वारभूतः तदंशत्वं श्रुतिर् जगौ.
Thereafter means after 14 chapters. He didn't study. It's okay. Understood. You understood all the 14 chapters. Take it for granted. We study so many Vedantic texts. Thereafter, here in this chapter, sense pleasure, okay? Sense pleasure, which is an enjoyer of the part of the bliss of Brahman. The sense pleasure is bliss of Brahman only. The Brahmananda, we are enjoying in the object. Vishayananda means a sense pleasure. Brahmananda Amsha. Amsha means a part. The Brahmanandam, Bhagavan, our Ramakrishna Paramahamsa says that, Brahmanandam is like a big ocean. Sukadeva is like a small mosquito. Sukadeva is like a mosquito.
What about ourselves?
Amoeba. Amoeba si amoeba. Sukadeva is a small mosquito enjoying this Brahmananda. That is the amount of... It is impossible to explain the Brahmananda. In Brahmananda Valley, it is explained. The Vedas have tried their best to explain Brahmananda in Brahmananda Valley, Taittiriya Upanishad. So the Brahmananda Amsha, small part, not Amsha, very drop of the Brahmananda, we are enjoying the pleasure, the worldly things. Nirupeti Tadwarabodha. Now we are going to study this Vishayananda. When we study the Vishayananda, this becomes the door. Being the gateway to and a part of that bliss. Thus the Shruti says, Shruti, because he has taken the topic based on Shruti. Shruti Parma. Many mantras are telling that when we take the Vishayananda, Vishayananda is none other than the reflection of Brahmananda. That's all. Now he has taken one part from the Shruti and started discussing. Why you are starting this subject unnecessarily? We have other job. What? Now I have to go for the sleep. Very important job. Now you have taken this and discussed why. When we discuss this, when we study the Vishayananda will take us towards the Brahmananda. So the sense pleasure, when we study the sense pleasure, this becomes the gateway to reach Brahmananda. Therefore, we are studying it. Just whatever we enjoy, you take that joy and study that. Behind the study, you find Brahmananda. For that only, we have taken up this study. Okay? So brilliant, very brilliant way of putting it. How he has started? What is Vishayananda? Eating mango, that's all. In India, you get only in season. There you get 365 days. I do not know where they are getting. Somewhere from heaven also. 365 days mangoes you are getting. In India only. But April, May, June. Anyway, the Vishayananda we study. Through the study of Vishayananda, we try to get Brahmananda. For that only we have taken this subject. Now,
ఏషోస్య పరమానందో యో అఖండైకరసాత్మక అన్యాని భూతాని ఏతస్య మాత్రమేవ ఉపభుంజతే. మాత్ర మీన్స్ స్మాల్ పార్ట్, వెరీ డ్రాప్. అఖండ రస, అఖండ రసాత్మక బ్రహ్మానంద, అఖండ రస బ్రహ్మాత్మ పరమానంద అన్యాని భూతాని ఆల్ ద జీవస్ ఫ్రమ్ యాంట్ ఫ్రమ్ యాంట్ వాట్ దట్ టిల్ అవర్ బ్రహ్మదేవ్ బ్రహ్మాది పిపీలికాంత పర్యంతం ఫ్రమ్ ద బ్రహ్మ టు ద అండ్ ఆల్ దిస్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ ఎంజాయింగ్ మాత్రం మాత్రం మీన్స్ డ్రాప్ ఆఫ్ ది బ్రహ్మం బ్రహ్మానంద ఇస్ ఎంజాయ్డ్ బై ఆల్ ద జీవా సర్వాణి భూతాని. ఓకే, శృతి సేస్ దాట్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద సుప్రీం బ్లిస్ విచ్ ఇస్ ఇండివిజిబుల్ అఖండ అండ్ హోమోజెనియస్ అండ్ అదర్ బీయింగ్స్ ఎంజాయ్ ఓన్లీ ద ఫ్రాక్షన్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ బ్లిస్ వాట్ ఎవర్ వి ఎంజాయ్ all the jivas whatever we enjoyed all the jivas which have enjoyed the that pleasure in the past in the present in the future all the pleasures put together okay all the pleasure put together is a drop of brahmananda matrameva upabunjate the same point is brought out by our bhagwan adi shankaracharya in atmabodh If you studied Atmabodham, then you can remember this. Otherwise, add it in your notes. That's all. Atmabodham. Some Bodham he has taken. What Bodham? Maybe Tattva Bodham. Okay. It is not discussed in Tattva Bodham. In Atmabodham, we get this sloka. 58th sloka. Bhagavan Adi Shankaracharya brings the same idea. Akhandananda rupasya tasyananda lavashritaha lavam. లవ అఖండ ఆనంద బ్రహ్మానంద లవ మీన్స్ వెరీ డ్రాప్ బ్రహ్మాది స్తంభ పర్యంతే ఫ్రమ్ ద బ్రహ్మాన్ క్రియేటర్ అండ్ అదర్ డైటీస్ ఓకే ద బ్రహ్మన్స్ నేచర్ ఇస్ ఇన్ఫినిట్ బ్లిస్ డిపెండింగ్ ఆన్ జస్ట్ స్మాల్ పార్టికల్ ఆఫ్ బ్లిస్ డూ ద క్రియేటర్ అండ్ అదర్ డైటీస్ బ్రహ్మాద్య తారతమ్యేన తారతమ్య మీన్స్ వాట్ దట్ the fluctuations will be there. Brahma will be enjoying more. The Devatas little lesser. And the Gandharvas little lesser. For us, very little. When you compare with animal, we are better. Birds, we are so better. Taratamyena. Bhavanti anandino akila. All this proportionally become blissful with their share of that particular. They get very happiness. All the happiness are reflection of Brahmananda. Brahmananda is ananda of the supreme ultimate truth or Lord. No religion will tell like this. You go all over the world and you ask that religion, what kind of pleasure you are enjoying? Pleasure we are enjoying by the grace of the Lord, that's all. Leave it. Do you know Brahmananda? What? Do you know what you are enjoying is a part of the Lord? What? No idea of this kind of highest for the thought. We are all very much blessed. We are very much blessed. Sometimes when we involve the studies, we forget our glory. Again and again, we have to remember the glory also. When you study this text, going to even small one class of Vedanta is not very ordinary thing. Few classes of Vedanta, understanding highest thought is not ordinary thing. You go anywhere in the world, no man will discuss this kind of highest thing. You are enjoying the pleasure of the Brahman, the Supreme Lord. Highest thought. Well, we have to have two parallel thoughts in our life. So one thought, studying the Vedantic text and understanding. Second thought, we are very much blessed. It's very, very rare to get this. But we are forgetting this. The blessings and the rarity, understanding the rarity. We are only interested in the understanding the Vedanta. I understood this thought. You don't understand. Therefore, I am great. Greater than you. I am senior also. I studied so many texts. Sir, when you study so many texts, understand this is your duty to share this knowledge to other people. He also should get that kind of message. He also came here to get this kind of knowledge. The person is eligible, then you have to share it. And always you have to remember, this is glorious culture we belong to. Nowhere you get this kind of thought.
Okay. So whenever we study Vedanta, understanding of the subject, at the same time, the glory of the subject also should come parallel. Okay. A frog in the well knows not. We are all like frog. Simply enjoying small, small things. That Deepavali comes, okay. Deepavali comes and you take some money, go to shop, get some necklace or necklace then. Necklace. And the gold and diamond necklace. Or 10 lakhs no chip. Or 10 lakhs too much. Story then. Have it. Story, we should not have a very miserly mind. Story then. 10 lakhs. Okay. Or $10,000. Am I right? Story then. Why you are looking so seriously? Or $10,000. $10,000. You have $10,000, spend $10,000 and get very nice thing. So you spend a little money and get necklace and you offered to your best part of your life. Next, what is better part? I don't know better part or best part. You have offered. Amma is very. And she is also very happy. Small activity, small thing we purchase from the shop, and very small 5-6 days. After that, that's all. The happiness will dilute. Hold on. The first day when you get it, you are very happy and you are wearing it and going and showing. And actually, we used to call the people through phone, but we used to call them video call. Video call. Why video call? Come on. Small happiness. This is what the frog in the well knows, not the ocean. So from the childhood, we trained ourselves in such a way that how to go around small, small, small happiness. Small happiness. After 2-3 days, it will get diluted. That's all. Again, we will go for another small happiness. Sir, there is another ocean. The frog should come out of the small, very small one and should come out and see the ocean. When you studied Vedanta, Vedanta opens up this gateway and shows what is real happiness. Right? So I'm not telling you should not get a necklace. You have to get it. So all the fathers should not say, no, it's a very nice time you are telling the story. We studied Panchadasi. In this Deepavali, you are not getting anything, okay? You don't live like a frog. Come out from the well, okay? Sir, I will come out. First, you get me the necklace, okay? After wearing the necklace, I will come out. First, you bring. So, we should not compromise our day-to-day transactional life. See, one thing, we have to be very, very conscious that we have to come out of the samsara. And another line, we have to live in the samsara brilliantly. Whatever the dharma, we have to follow dharma. Following dharma and living in the samsara, over the world, at the same time, another track, we have to get ready to come out of the samsara. So what happens when you study one or two texts of Vedanta, immediately we'll drop all the things of samsara, then we'll try completely to follow the spiritual thing. We are not following that also, we are losing this also, we are standing in between. This is called Naduthirul Nikkaradhu. Sandhila Nikkara. In Tamil, it's a Sandhila Nikkara. Sandhi means not here, not here. So it's a very brilliant kind of life we have to lead. We have to be very, very conscious of this, the life where we are living. So we should have money, we should know how to spend it. And we should have gold and we should go over that, safeguard it, all the things. At the same time, we have to understand the impermanency of the thing and we have to live. At the same time, we have to understand the Vedantic concept slowly, slowly, slowly. We have to get out of the thing. A brilliant kind of the balance we need to get. Okay? Now, three kinds of modifications. Three kinds of modifications. Now, the subject is getting started. Three kinds of modifications. This Vishayananda is a gateway to get Brahmananda, he told. Now, the subject is started. Three kinds of modifications. Shanta, Gora, Tata, Moodha. Manaso Vrataya Strida, Vairagyam Kshanti Audaryam, Ityadhyaha, Shanta Vrataya. Now the subject is started. The modifications of the mind are three kinds. Modifications of the mind. Our mind has got modification. According to Panchadasi, three kind. According to our life, so many kinds. I have modification. Modification, no modification, my mind. Vyavahara world, we have so many modifications. In the science of Vedanta, this is science of Vedanta. It has got three modifications. Siriyan, agitated and dull. Vairagyam, kshanti, audaryam. This is not, sorry. Shanta, gora, mudha. Yeah. Shanta means Siriyan. Siriyan, shanta. Very common. Very calm, silent. Now we are experiencing this. Shanta. Half eye is closed now, slowly. Half shanta. After the class, full shanta. Siriyan, calm. Shanta. Ghora. Ghora means what that? Very turbulent. Yeah. Agitated. Word also very... This person is very brilliant person. Vidyanya Swami. Shanta Ghora. Shanta herself becomes Ghora. Ghora Murti. Now you look like so Shanta. Now you say, my name is Shanta. My name was Shanta. Now I am Ghora. The same mind. Another Ghora Murti. Muda. Same mind. Muda Murti. Names are very good. Who is Shanta? My name is. Who is Gora? She. Muda. We cannot take a nice name for us. All we have the three names for our mind. Shanta, Gora, Muda. Okay. So when you read this, Manasaha Vrittaya Strida. Three kinds of modification of mind. So one is Shanta, Gora, and another one is Muda. Vairagyam. Vairagyam means what that? Detachment. Detachment, accommodativeness. Kshanti, audaryam. The large-heartedness. All these positive qualities are Shantavrittaya. Shantavritti means all the positive. Devi Sampath. All the Deva Sampath is called Shantavritti. Okay? When you read this shloka, you remember, definitely you remember the 14th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Sattva, Rajas, Tamas. So many mind is working behind. Same point here. Why? Again, Sattva, Rajas, Tamas. Wherever we go, Sattva, Rajas, Tamas, Sattva, Rajas, Triguna. You boring here. Even 1,000 times also when we hear Sattva, Rajas, Tamas, we should not get bored. We have to train our mind in that way. So when we get this boring kind of mind, when we hear the same point again and again, then our mind health is not in good condition. So if you are very healthy, even 1,000 times also you read Ramayana, you have to get taste. Even 100 times you are hearing the same subject, you should not lose the taste. Then we are in the right path. Getting it? How many years now we are, or that more than 70 years old, still we are drinking tea, coffee without any boring feeling. You are right. 70 years we are drinking the same coffee. And day by day, attachment is getting so deeper. Yes. In the same way, we have to get that kind of attachment with a taste of the subject. Because when you study Tattu Bodha Bhajakonda, I know. Why you are I know. What do you know? Triguna. What is Brahman? Satchitananda. Understanding small things. And we are satisfied. And after that, it's boring. So that is not good mental condition. Because the spiritual path, you will get boring, you will get bored very quickly. And nothing is there. Same point again and again. Same Brahman. So we are studying same Brahman more than in our 50 years. Same Brahman only. Not next week, new Brahman will not come. Same Brahman. Same old Brahman. Same Maya. Same Triguna. In this path, very easy to get bored. But you have to be very, very careful, and you have to maintain that heat always. The mind. Okay? Okay. Triguna. So it reminds the Triguna of Bhagavad Gita 14th chapter. The Shantavritti is, what is Shantavritti? Vairagyam, Kshanti, Audharyam. All the good qualities are Shantavritti. That's all. Three kinds of vritti. Then what is Ghora vritti? Trishna, Sneha, Raga, Loba, Ityade, Ghora vrittaya. Love for objects. Trishna, Sneha, attachment. Raga, Raga Loba. Again, attachment, Loba, greed. All this Ityade, Ghora vrittaya. Ghora means agitated. The Rajoguna. And Muda vrittaya, Sammoha, Bhaya, Ityade. The delusion, fear, all these things, dull modifications, agitated modifications. Shanta vritti, sattva guna. Ghora vritti, rajo guna. And here, muda vritti, tamo guna. Simple. And same subject we should have studied in Bhagavad Gita. Why are you bringing in Panchadasi and changing the name, sir? Sir, actually, 14th chapter, just leave it. We studied then already. Why are you bringing in Panchadasi? Change the name only. Wait. Changing the name. Wait. And then in the transaction world, we tell speed, RPM of the circle. Revolution per second, revolution per minute. Speed. But if you go to engineering background, so they say torque. What torque? Torque. Speed. The language is getting or the changed from place to place. Same meaning. So little the technical name will be changed. So for what purpose our Vidyaranya Swami has brought this change of name in this chapter? There is a reason for this. In Bhagavad Gita 14th chapter, Gunatraya Vibhaga Yogam, just like we will study, then we will move little forward, okay? Krishna says, Sattvam Rajasthamaiti Guna Pagati Sambhavaha Tan Nibandhanti Ko Mahabaho Dehe Dehe Namavyam. Sattva Rajas Tamas, the three gunas. Sattva Rajas, three gunas are binding the jiva. Okay? I'm not elaborating, just I'm touching and going. Sattva Guna. Tatra Sattvam Nirmalatvat Prakashakam Anamayam Sukha Sangena Badnadi Jnana Sangena Chanaka. Sattva Guna, if you have, you are attached with Sukham and Jnanam. That's all. Sattva is good, very good. Karma Sangena. Rajo Radna Rajatmakam Vidya Ragatmakam Vidya Trishna Sangha Samudbhavam. Tannibadnadi kaundeye karma sangena dehinam. So rajoguna is very dynamic and active. It binds us with the activities. Okay. Tamoguna. Tamastu ajnanajam vidhi mohanam sarva dehinam. It's getting out that. It brings the delusion to the jiva. Pramada alasya nidrabihi. Very nice. Pramada alasya nidrabihi. Forgetting all the things, sleeping, forgetting everything. Last week you studied, not last week. Yesterday what I studied, I forgot. What about last week? Last year, ayayyo. Pramada alasya. Alasya means for that. Fomirita. Dullness, okay? Laziness. Tannibadnadi bharat. Okay? Now when I study Bhagavad Gita 14th chapter, all the values are given. If you get this kind of vritti, we are in tamoguna. If you have this kind of vritti, rajoguna, this kind of vritti, sattoguna. What Krishna says, Trigunya Vishaya Veda Nistraigunya Bhava Arjuna. Arjuna, my advice is you have to go beyond the Trigunada. So how to go? First you cross the tamoguna. After that, you cross over rajoguna. Then you reach sattoguna. Nistraigunya, you have to go. Nitya sattvasto, you have to stand the sattoguna. From the sattoguna, you have to get out of sattvaguna also. So very brilliant kind of advice is given by Bhagavan Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. Okay? We're getting it? Okay. We studied this. Now, you have water. The water, two kinds of the thing. One is a transactional function, another is technical details. What is the transactional function? You take the water and make coffee, make tea, make juice, all the things. Okay? Pour here and there and take the water, clean the floor. And if you have little water, you just throw on other people with the color water. It becomes holy functional. So with water, you can do anything. In a functional, the transactional function, the day-to-day activity, we use this water. Another thing is technical details of the water. What is the combination of hydrogen and oxygen? You have to bring in this proportion, you get water. If you heat the water, it becomes steam. If you cool the water, it becomes what that ice cube. All the technical things about the water and the functional use of the water. Do you understand this? Excuse me. All right. Now, the three gunas, Bhagavan Krishna is explained in Bhagavad Gita in different way. Panchadesh is going to discuss, handle the three gunas in different way. That's all. The same three guna only. Bhagavan Krishna is handling there. He says, if you get this kind of vritti, you understand this is tamas. This is rajas, this is sattvara. You understand this. And you have to move from sattva, tamo to rajo, rajo to sattva. And you have to get out of this three guna. So this is only the functional aspect of the three gunas are explained in Bhagavad Gita. Even common man can follow this. Are you getting it? Common man can understand Bhagavad Gita. That is very, very, very easily. Functional. How to use water, that's all. In Panchadasi, he takes us towards the laboratory. Hey, you come to laboratory, I will explain technical details. So our Vidyaranya Swami is taking us from, so we are in kitchen and enjoying this Panchadasi, Bhagavad Gita and eating. Bhagavan Lord Krishna is so compassionate, he comes down and he is serving the food. They are consuming it. And our Panchadasi, our Swami, Vidyaranya is taking us, you come to laboratory, I will tell you a few more things. So technical details is going to explain the same Triguna. This is what we are going to study in Panchadasi. Are you getting it? The two great acharyas. So one is Jagadguru Krishna Vande Jagadguru, Lord Krishna. Another one is our. So our nature is we do Ashtotra Sadanamavali, Sahasranama for Lord Krishna. And an Acharya Puja. Guru Puja, Guru. That's, we worship and we'll keep them there itself. Sir, you have to bring this great teachers of the world, great professors of the world. Krishna Mandati, when you take Bhagavad Gita, see the professional approach of the professor. Every professor in the world should study Bhagavad Gita. Content is different. The way he expressed, the way he conducted the class, you will learn so much. Psychology involved, thought flow involved, and curiosity of the student, how to increase the curiosity of the student is involved. Psychology of the student and the teacher is involved in Bhagavad Gita. So how to give? So he finished the second chapter, third chapter, student is asking question. Krishna, I have a question. For that only I stop here. Now you ask the question. Then only discussion will follow. Interesting person. So we are missing that academic part, all scientific part of the Bhagavad Gita. We need to have devotion. Okay, devotion is okay. So our too much of devotion is hiding this part of science and academic aspect. So we have to control our devotion to get this science of Bhagavad Gita and psychology of Bhagavad Gita. I hope you are getting that, the line. Okay, the great Krishna is talking about the three gunas for the function purpose. Okay, here he comes. I'll tell you the technical details, how to study. So this part we'll take up tomorrow. Okay. So this is the Panchadasis, 15 chapters content. Very brilliant person. The Vidyaranya Swami is a very brilliant person. So this is the person's, the form is the puja hall. Suppose you take this kavi dress on, you put all the coat, this and that, remove this, put small chandan. Okay? Ask him to talk in English. Great professor of powerful university. We have to look them in this view. So if anybody asks, then we can tell what kind of knowledge we have in India. Brilliant. Nowhere in the world people can present this knowledge this way. In the name of spirituality and religion, we are not able to get out their abilities, the brilliant brain outside. So we are responsible for that. I hope you understood how we have to present these people. Rishas, great teacher. Okay, va? So functional aspect of gunas explained by Lord Krishna. There's no, we cannot say which is the better, this better. The both are our people. Both are our teachers. Here the question is not who is better and who is not better. No. Both are better. So how he handles. That's all. So he is a scholarly person. He takes us towards the laboratory. He's a very compassionate person and brings this value to the common man. Both are very great. Abhavan Maharaj sitting there and writing on a very high level. Gurudev understood and brings that to the common person to lift us. So we cannot say who is greater, who is less. No, both are great. The function is a little different. Okay? So tomorrow we'll continue this subject. Very nice subject. You will enjoy the thoughts. Good thoughts are there in this 15th chapter. Okay? I think today you don't have any question. You will not have a question because today you study. Tomorrow definitely will have a question. So tomorrow we'll have question answer session. Okay. After 1 hour we'll have, then half an hour we'll have question answer session. Have you understood today the topic? Yeah. So when you study the scriptures, we have to bring the scriptures for our day-to-day activity. We have to study in that way. Otherwise, simply I go to a class, I study Vedanta, I come back. So you study Vedanta, how you apply? I study, that's all. Vedanta student, I studied. You studied the bulk of the big book. But even small, single point also you're not able to bring out your day-to-day life. Then what is the use? Okay? The three things. One is studying the Vedanta, bringing the Vedanta into our life, and understanding glory of Sanatana Dharma. Three things should come. So what happens in Navali, where I go to Vedanta class, I study, there itself we get satisfaction. I studied so many texts. Have you studied Panchadasi? Yeah. Viveka Churamani? Brahma Sutra? 18th chapter? 10 years back. So you studied all. I should not say that, but I studied. Anyway, my children are not listening to my words. Only that problem I have, that's all. Otherwise, I have everything in my life. You studied all the scriptures, you are crying. Vyavahara is different from Paramarthika, no. And you have one more point from the Vedanta to compromise your negative values. Okay, tomorrow we'll see. Shall I conclude? Nice class, right? Very nice class. You are all very nice students, listening attentively. So without sleeping in the class, very brilliant quality. Because this is for us early morning. For it's night. Nice time for the class for you. This is a good topic, the 15th chapter. When you finish the topic, you'll understand complete view of this topic. You have to appreciate the glory of the teacher. No? What kind of teacher this? Vidyaranya. The name itself is Vidya Aranya. Aranya of Vidya, the forest of Vidya. You don't know what kind of knowledge he has got. Forest. Another person, Madhusudana Saraswati. Sada Saraswati, the people are telling he is none other than the avatar of Saraswati, Madhusudana Saraswati. Another person. We belong to great, glorious tradition. Our people are great scholars. At the same time, very compassionate. The Vidya Dadati Vinayam. They study, they create so many big, big books, but very, very compassionate, very, very ordinary person. People. not very ordinary. I am not telling in that sense very ordinary. Simple, very simple. Compassionate. Therefore, they become saint. Why is called a saint? He is called at the same time, he is very saintly man. He has given the subject to us. Scholar is only intellectual. When we study, when we become scholar, we become so egoistic. Why scholar? Egoistic. I know. I am better than you. This kind of feeling will be there. Why this person is called a saintly person? All our scholars in India, they studied and they are bringing down to the earth for the common man. Therefore, we are worshipping them. This is the difference between the Eastern and the Western, the style of presentation. The Eastern world, all the people, all the professors were saintly people. You take all the Shad Darshana, Darshanas as presented by great saints. Yeah, Sankhya, Yoga, Nyaya, Vaisheshika, Uttaramimamsa, Purvamimamsa, all these people found a saintly people. Great philosopher. That is the glory of India. Okay?
Yeah, okay. You are right.
Side by side, we have to understand the glory of India also. Glory of Sanatana Dharma. Instead of simply studying this text, right? The glory part. What kind of personalities these people? From Alpharetta and Atlanta, all the students are very serious students. Looking at me like this. You are brilliant. Studying very well. Good. So we have to thank this technology. I don't know who made this great board. I'm using it as much as possible. Very brilliant board. East and West coming together. Eastern knowledge of Brahma Vidya is presenting through Western technology. Yeah? Okay, va? So tomorrow you bring some question, we'll discuss. ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति 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 हरिः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम